Given a dictionary or a counter object from the collections module, we'd like to know how many unique words there are in a given book. We'd also like to return the frequencies of each word, meaning count specifying how many times each word has appeared. To do this, we'll be writing a wordstats function. Our function is going to be called wordstats, short for word statistics, and the input is going to be word counts, which is returned to us by the other function we previously wrote. The first thing we want to accomplish is to count the number of unique words. To do that, we can take the word counts object and simply ask what is the length of that object. We know that each entry in the dictionary is going to be unique, and therefore the length of that object is going to return to us the number of unique keys we have, meaning the number of unique words. I'm going to call this number unique, numUnique for short. And this accomplishes the first part. The second task is to return the word counts for every single unique word in the dictionary. We'll start with the word counts dictionary. We'd like to extract the values, the counters from this object, which we do using the values method. I'm going to simply call this counts, and that's the frequencies of each word in our text. Finally, we need to return these two objects, so we'll be returning a tuple which consists of numUnique and counts. Let's add a short docstring. We can do just a simple one-line docstring here saying return number of unique words and word frequencies. Let's then try running our function. Let's first read in the text, the book. Here is the path to our Romeo and Juliet. So we've just read in the text. Then let's count the words. So word counts is equal to count words in text. And then we can ask the wordstats to return the number of unique words and the word frequencies to us. If we look at the contents of number unique, we know that Romeo and Juliet has a total of 5,118 unique words. If we'd like to know how many words there are in total, we can do a sum of the counts, and it's approximately 41,000. Let's use the wordstats function to compare Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet in English with its German translation. I will first take the code that we have here, and I will copy-paste that in the editor above. So we first read the text, we then perform the word counts, and then we run our wordstats function on what we just read. All of these operations will be identical for the German version, except for the name of the book. We first have to go to our German directory, and in German it's called Romeo und Julia. Then we'll just add print function here, number unique and sum counts. That takes care of that. We'll use the same exact line here. We'll create a little space here. And let's try running this. We know the result for English, same as before, which is good. We'll do the same operation for the German version, and we'll find that the outcome is a little different. The German translation of Romeo and Juliet appears to contain about 7,500 words, but in length it's about 20,000.